Home is where my mind is. Sometimes it is folded up in between my daydreams, recycled up in the clouds. Sometimes it sits in quiet spaces where no one else lives. Not even the sound of my thoughts can penetrate it. Not the breath of my insecurities, nor the whisper of my worries. At times, it thumbs over sweet memories, appearing like a pop-up bug. And other times, it is wild, like cascades, falling down, untamed, only to land gently into my riverbed of a hat. Home is where my heart is, and it weaves in anything that looks bright and promising, beautiful and peaceful, surprising and exciting, kind and understanding. And yes, it is also valiant, for at times it welcomes the unknown, the uncertain, the indefinable. It lends itself to be a platform, an umbrella, a roof to whoever wishes to be protected by it. Home is where my feet are. They plant themselves like mighty trees, make roots that are earth core deep, stand magnificent like mountains, remain heavy like boulders, and when the atmosphere tips them a different way, sends them off to other places, they become flexible like bamboo stalks, drag along an anchor to give signal from above, or mark on the ground, a map to the color of our being. We were here, to whoever wishes to know. We were here, and they can follow it if they want. Home is where my mind, my heart, my feet are, and they are ever changing, ever evolving, melting into the pockets of the tangible world I never thought I'd fuse with, diving into the human layers I never thought I'd own, opening like opportunities I never thought I'd get a hold of and go.
Dear Fremont, you're overrated, expensive, and have terrible traffic, but I still miss you. You're not just a location of my house and family, but a time machine to some of my greatest memories. I miss the festival, the Indian culture preserved in you. I miss your streets, your smell, your food, especially the samosas. I miss taking the bar to San Francisco and breathing the fresh, misty air in the evenings of the hilly city. Fremont, you gave me my identity. I feel both Indian and American within you. We, after all, have the best boba and the samosas in the US, and we invented curry pizza. Moved to many places, but called you home, because you provide the comfort I do not find anywhere else.
They stood on a beach with feathers and And when I woke up, it was a new age. And when I woke up, there was no more rage. And when I woke up, I was center stage. And when I woke up, I was my own sage. And then I woke up, I woke up, I woke up, I woke up.
Today. My name is Chuyun. I'm an assistant professor of dance history at SDSU and also the director of Refugee Dance Project. Refugee Dance Project is my ethnographic research. And what I do for this research is that I first provide dance and movement workshop for the refugee community and then interview the participants and create a public performance with members of the community. Since 2016, I've worked with more than 50 refugees from Iran, Iraq, Syria, China, and Thailand, and presenting performances across New York, California, and Texas. The project first started in Utica, New York, 2016, when I was working as a visiting assistant professor at Hamilton College. In partnership with Midtown Utica Community Center, I closely worked with teenage refugees from Thailand and created a public performance, which was presented in Clinton, New York, 2017. The performance shows how we support each other when we go through a difficult time. It also has my solo performance, where I incorporate shamanic folk dance, which has been used for exorcism and ritual for centuries in South Korea, which I will present you today after this presentation. The last scene shows a list of people who were refugees, but now considered someone changed the world, including Sigmund Freud. The show culminates with a text saying that being a refugee is not a choice. Supporting them to change the world is a choice. The performance was also presented at National Communication Association and received Top Contributed Performance Award from Performance Studies Division. Dancer Home is my current refugee dance project in San Diego. It wouldn't be possible without the generous support from PSFA Project for Public Good Grant. In partnership with License to Freedom and Musical Ambassador of Hope, the workshop first began in Cajon since I joined a drum circle led by Ari, a member of Musical Ambassador of Hope. And then since then, the workshop has been provided in many different locations, including public library, church, backyard, and finally, thanks to the generous grant in a dance studio, where we started building the movement for Dance of Home. Many of the participants are women and children from Iran, Iraq, and Syria. A lot of them are highly educated and worked as a professor, engineer, lawyer, and nationally known artist in their home country. But here, they face a lot of difficulty because of linguistic barrier, financial, and social status as refugees, in addition to discrimination against race, gender, ethnicity, citizenship, and religion. But they come to the workshop because dancing is joyful, makes them feel happier, and allows them to escape from the harsh reality, albeit temporary. But not all workshops ended with a smile. Sometimes we cried, we made an argument, because dancing as a storytelling could evoke trauma and deep emotional feelings. So today, you will see such a brave group of women who have been staying with me throughout the process and willingly and generously share their voices. Some of the movement and music are directly generated by members of the community. At the end of the workshop process, we created a drawing under the guidance by Najula. She's a nationally known painter. And then we wrote a letter to home, which you will see in the final performance. So today we have nothing but dance. But we hope that dancing could be powerful enough to heal us, help us move forward, so that everyone belongs here, and we belong to everyone and everywhere.
minor fall and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to her kitchen chair, and she broke your throne, and she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew broken, hallelujah, hallelujah.